Ever since the coronavirus pandemic gripped the world, no one wants to deal with China for the irresponsible hegemon that it has become. At least, the free world doesn't want to talk or negotiate with Beijing. But there is one bloc, the European Union, that wants to strengthen its ties with China despite its irresponsible handling and cover-up of the COVID-19 outbreak. As per latest reports, a summit was supposed to be held between the Chinese President Xi Jinping and the 27 European Union leaders, hosted by the de facto EU head German Chancellor Angela Merkel in Germany this September. The summit, however, now stands rescheduled, though not cancelled, given the prevailing COVID situation. However, Chinese state media has reported that the EU is engaging in talks with China for finalizing an investment treaty. CCP mouthpiece Global Times has reported the 10th round of China-EU high-level strategic dialogue was held on Tuesday, where the two sides discussed bilateral relations and matters of shared interest, which analysts believe will pave the way for the China-EU summit and an investment treaty. Xinhua News, another Chinese state media agency, has reported that the European Union and Beijing held the 10th round of high-level strategic dialogue on Tuesday via video link. The high-level dialogue was co-chaired by the Chinese Foreign Minister and EU High Representative for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy, Josep Borrell. EU is saving the day for Beijing at a time when it is facing a relentless global backlash. It is rather egregious on part of this intergovernmental bloc to engage China in trade talks and hold high-level meetings with Beijing instead of standing up to the country's high-handed approach in world affairs. The EU has emerged as a spineless intergovernmental organization playing mind-bending games for quite some time that has weakened the democratic world's battle against the autocratic communist regime in China. By going soft on China, the EU is making leaders like Trump and Scott Morrison look bad. And all this while the European Union member countries are themselves some of the worst hit countries amid coronavirus pandemic. More than 1 lakh people have died in the EU member states. We know for a fact that it was Beijing which hit the pandemic for far too long. The virus had emerged in November 2019 itself, but till January 24th, it kept claiming that there was no human-to-human transmission. China also used its corrupt influence in the World Health Organization to ensure that European countries did not impose a travel ban on China. China-WHO collusion tricked Europe into allowing incoming passenger traffic from the country of coronavirus origin. EU quickly became an epicenter of the pandemic, and this is when millions got infected and lakhs died in Europe. In the succeeding months, the European Union has failed to stand up for its own member countries. It almost seems that the EU is more interested in doing good PR for Beijing rather than safeguarding the interests of its own member states. In the past few months, the EU has succumbed to Chinese influence again and again. First, it dialed down a report about China's state-backed disinformation campaign. Then, it allowed the Chinese state media to censor an op-ed co-authored and co-signed by all European Union ambassadors to China. Here, the Chinese media removed a reference to the coronavirus pandemic. Last month, 100 countries rallied behind each other to draft a resolution in the 73rd World Health Assembly to review the response of the World Health Organization in order to draw lessons from it. EU authored it and Australia backed it. It seemed as if China was on the back foot, but EU fooled the whole world and embarrassed Canberra by making no mention of Wuhan or China. The European Union is backing China not only in terms of coronavirus pandemic, but also in the terms of the dragon's hawkish military attitude. China has been behaving belligerently in the South China Sea and elsewhere, which prompted the NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg to say, "The rise of China is fundamentally shifting the global balance of power, multiplying the threats to open societies and individual freedoms, and increasing the competition over our values and our way of life." But the European Union Foreign Affairs Chief Josep Borrell says, "China has a global ambition, but at the same time, I don't think that China is playing a role that can threaten the world peace." In fact, the top-level EU diplomat keeps saving the day for China again and again. Recently, on the question of Hong Kong, he said, I don't think that sanctions are the way to solve problems in China. It seems that the EU is in self-destruction mode, as the German Chancellor and de facto EU head Angela Merkel keeps playing into the hands of Beijing. EU members like Czech Republic, Estonia, Sweden and France have spoken against Chinese aggression, but the EU keeps downplaying such voices. What the coronavirus pandemic has also triggered is an economic recession apart from deaths. EU countries like Spain and France are the worst hit, but EU hasn't helped them, and leaders like Germany, which are economically better off, have refused corona bonds. The EU is supposed to fend for itself by creating a massive $18 trillion bloc, but by refusing to help out Italy, the EU is only vindicating Brexit and encouraging an Italexit. The top leadership is allowing the EU to disintegrate and collapse, which would ultimately allow China to fill the vacuum in countries like Italy that are troubled by the coronavirus-induced slowdown. The top leadership of the EU should have ideally stood up against China when the US was getting gripped by the COVID-19 pandemic and Europe was coming out of it. But the EU has deliberately refused to take a clear-cut China policy. The EU leadership has given the way to a divided bloc, and China hasn't hesitated to make the most out of it. If the EU has to collapse anyway, the member countries may as well form different blocs according to their needs instead of allowing Beijing to take control of the European continent.